I want to look at the Segments and Normals sections of the 3D Effects toolbar. I'm grouping these together because it will be easier to see the segments change and how they work with different normals. A normal is just a straight line perpendicular to that surface that influences how the surface of the object is rendered. In other words, it will have an effect on the way the object looks with different colors, textures, and lighting. When we look at the different icons under the normals, we'll see little arrows going away from the shape, representing what a normal would look like. Let's add a 3D shape. It looks like my 3D toolbar is not on our drawing toolbar. It was on there, I thought. I just upgraded to LibreOffice 4. I right-clicked on the little dots on our toolbar, and we're on the Toolbars tab. I'm going to scroll down a little bit, and it appears our 3D Objects toolbar has become unchecked. I'm just checking it and adding it back to our toolbar, clicking OK. I'm going to tear off my toolbar and set it to the side here. I'm going to add a sphere. Control-C, Control-V, because we want an exact copy. Moving it next to it, we'll move this one over a little bit. And we want one more, Control-C, Control-V, and move that one over. Now we got our three spheres exactly alike. We can see this one on the left is an object specific. I'm going to select the one on the right and make that one spherical, selecting and assigning. And we don't see that it changed much. Now I'm selecting the one in the middle, and I'm going to click on the flat. Now that one we've got an obvious change. And it looks like we've got little lines and flat surfaces that make up our sphere. If I change these in our segments, I'll make this one 8 and this one 6. Clicking OK, we can see in our preview what it's going to look like. And it's pretty clear now how many lines we have from top to bottom and side to side. If we do the same thing with our spherical, I'm going to make this 8. Make this one 6. And we can see that it's trying to make a sphere out of a frame with not too many lines underneath making up our sphere. Now, if I select our flat surface and max it out to 256 and assign that, we see that we have what looks like a spherical shape, even though it's made up of those flat surfaces. The more segments we have, the smoother the object. But the problem with this is, when I go to move it, we see how slow that one moved, whereas when I move this one, it moves a lot quicker because there's less segments it has to render or to put together each time. So depending on your machine, you may see a quicker or slower response than that. And I'm going to change this one back down to 8 and 6. Now I'm selecting our spherical object, and I want to change the invert normal by turning that on. We see in our preview it makes the dark sides light and the light side dark, or it moves our light source to the opposite side. Assigning that, we see it does just what we thought. When we select our flat normals and click on invert normals, nothing happens to our preview and nothing happens when we assign it. So invert normals does not work when we have flat normals. When we have object specific, we see it will work in the preview, and assigning it, it does. I'm going to turn this off and turn it off here. That brings us down to double-sided illumination and double-sided. I'm going to insert a new slide for that. Now I'm going to insert a shell or a bowl from our 3D Objects toolbar. And we see that our double-sided is already selected. If I turn this off, we only see the one side of our bowl. because when we look at our normals, it's only showing the little arrows from one side. But if I click on double-sided, we want to see normals from both sides of our object. There we have our one side, and now the inside of our bowl is visible because of our normals. And our last normal is this double-sided illumination. Turning that on adds a little light, so we've got light coming from two sides, making it easier to see our bowls or our shells. Moving this to the side a little bit, doing a Control C, Control V, we've got an exact copy, and they are both with the object specific. Now I've got the one on the right selected. I'm going to make this one spherical because we didn't see too much change in that when we had the spheres on the other slide. So I'm going to make this one spherical. So here we do see a difference between our spherical and our object-specific normal.